What's good? We back with the Boston Clinic of Morris, your boy CJ Goodfellow. Y'all know what it is. Back grinding, scratching, clawing. Another video today. Earlier this morning, we dropped a Crawford video. Hopefully, you guys seen it about his Slade contract with Top Rank. But we here. We talking about the Showtime doubleheader. One part of it is two main events from a split venue. First, that's going to be fighting on Showtime this Saturday, May 19th. It's going to be Joseph Diaz, the challenger, coming over from Golden Boy. You know, I think he's from Cali, Southpaw. Amazing, talented fighter, man. I underrated him until I watched the film. He's an amazing fighter. Then you got Gary Russell, WBC featherweight champion, which very well might be his last fight at featherweight. He gonna move up to 130, I think, try to fight Miguel Burchett if he gets past Joseph Diaz, also known as Jojo Diaz, Al Haymon Premier Boxing Champion fighter. So, it's a good fight. You know, open statements. Absolutely good fight. Potentially could be the fighter tonight. Jojo Diaz is definitely was underrated by me. Amazing fighter. Gary Russell, good fighter. I think this is a 60-40 type of fight. I think I give Joseph Diaz that much more of a chance than everybody else. But let's get into it. Joseph Diaz strength. He's a southpaw. He got 2 inches on Russell officially, and they got the same arm length. I don't know, Gary Russell arm length was as long as they was. He like a little dinosaur in there, you know. And his strength is for him is his he got good speed. I'm gonna say it's his best strength in this fight, but he got good speed. You know, he's not elite level speed or a really, really once in a lifetime generation S type speed like Gary Russell, Amir Khan, guys with that type of hand speed. But he got good speed, you know. Also he got a good overhand left. He's a southpaw. He got a good left hand in general, straight left. He got a good right hand to the body. You know, he's an excellent body puncher, you know, with both hands. He can go to the body. He got a good jab. You know, I'm gonna say it's like the greatest jab ever. But solid. But his overhand left and his right hand to the body is his two best punches. He can mix the uppercut in there as well. And also for him, he's good at punching with you. He's a good counter puncher. He'll punch with you. You know, and that's something that Gary Russell could do as well. So that's what's gonna make this fight very, very good. To get off the topic for a minute. He can punch with you, he's a good counter puncher. He don't mind standing in a lion's mouth and fighting with you. He can fight on the inside. He can fight in the pocket. And same as Gary Russell. Fighting the inside. Fighting the pocket. Mid-range. If you don't know what the pocket is. You know. That's him. You know, Gary Russell. Obviously, you know what he bring. A lot of speed. He bring once in a generation type speed. He's a good puncher. Good left hook. Good jab. Good right hand. He throw pretty much a lot of good punches. You know. He's just so fast with his combination. Good combination puncher. As well as Jojo Diaz is a good combination puncher as well. I got to drop that in there. And Gary Russell goes to the body as well. You know, I watched the tape, the more I seen that he's able to get his opponent's guard down because he speed punches to the body. And it's thudding. He got good power as well. He's a better puncher than Jojo Diaz. I will say that. But for him, he's a good counter puncher too. You know, he'll pick your punch it off. He can catch and shoot with the same hand. That's something that Danny Garcia do good. I mean, when somebody throw a punch, he catch it on the arm and deliver it with the same hand. And that gets a lot of people. And that's how he scores, you know, that's how he hurts people and scores some knockdowns. So, I think he's an underrated defensive fighter as well, too. He's more offense. But while I watch on film, his feet, you know, he knows when he gets out of range. You know, he don't go straight back with his chin up. You know, he'll step to the side or, you know, if he pulls straight back, he'll keep his chin a little bit, you know, lower, you know. So he's underrated. He got good feints as well, too. His feint game is nice. And I think anytime he was fast as him and Pacquiao was fast, that feint is really what get people. So, you know, he got underrated defense, man. I seen that on film myself. But going into the weaknesses, Gary Russell, for some reason, I just question his chin. I don't know why, because he probably got that big head and that little body. I don't know, man. I don't know why. I just question it. Probably not valid. But also, his, you know. For his inactivity, man. He only fight once a year. I know he got the hand problems, but his inactivity, man, that's going to give Jojo Diaz a big chance to win. That's where the majority of that 40% I'm giving him is just based on Russell's inactivity. He might not be able, you know, to be the greatest long-range fighter, you know, but he does some things from long range that is good there. It seemed like his head don't is just right in the middle, but he does move his feet to get out of the way. And that's pretty much it with Gary Russell, man. And his hands. The hands is another big one that can give Joseph Diaz an extra 5%. He's susceptible to hand injuries, you know. And when you're not active, you know, injuries come to haunt you, and like hand injuries as well. But Joseph Diaz, he's not effective as like with Gary Russell, but I think Gary Russell's more effective going backwards than I gave him credit for. But Joseph Diaz, when I seen on film, he's not as effective going backwards on the back foot as he is going forward, you know. And I see that he pulls back with his chin straight up in the air, and we'll get to that in a minute. That could be a problem. He don't have great power at 126. He don't. He's a good puncher, but his power is not elite. I think it's above average to almost fringe, all right, good. Experience level. You know, he ain't fought nobody on this level. But what's in his favor is that Gary Russell, he ain't really got the greatest experience level neither, but he fought some better fighters than Joseph Diaz. But Gary Russell's been inactive, so that's working for him. But experience, and let me say this as a strength for Joseph Diaz before I go into the final statement and the keys to victory. He's been active. That's something to say for that. He's been very, very active. So, you know, for Diaz, you know, the power ain't the greatest. I mean, he when he goes backward, his chin goes up. He takes chances and punches with you. So, like I said, this is gonna be a great fight. You know, as far as the keys to victories for Gary Russell. Push this guy back, you know, push him back. Wait for him to punch. He's slower than you, and Joseph Diaz is probably the second fastest featherweight that I seen on film, as far as the elites. So he ain't no slouch in the speed department. So Joseph Diaz is really, really active, you know. He's a good body puncher. So Russell gotta take advantage when he starts digging to the body, time him and come upstairs to hit, and that's why a lot of fighters don't like to go to the body. It leaves the head available. And when he goes to the body, he loves to throw both hands behind it. So, you know, Russell needs to look for that opportunity to punch with Diaz as well. His hands are faster, and his punches seem to be shorter and get there quicker. Push him back, because when Joseph Diaz go back, he's not as effective as he is on the front foot, and his chin goes straight up in the air. So, you know, feint him, get him to, pop up, and then, you know, rush him with your speed and your power. Jab is going to be imperative for Russell. I think he got a better jab. He does change the speed on the jab. He's starting to, you know, learn from the Lomachenko mistakes. And for him, and sneak those body shots as well in, because Diaz is going to go to the body, you know. So Russell don't commit to the body like Diaz does, but he spots to the body, and it accumulates the good body work. He'll punch you here and then go upstairs and fire upstairs. And, like, every now and again, it'll catch you off guard. For Diaz, go to the body. You know, you're going to give up some head shots. But make sure you ain't close, and you stepping off to the side when you shoot those body shots, man. Don't stay right in the middle and keep your head right between that guard, because Russell will split that guard with that uppercut. I think he hurt Johnny Gonzalez with an uppercut. Rip the body, but you got to step over. You can't sit there. Once you rip that body, you got to tie Russell up or push him back with your body. Because if you rip the body, he gonna time you, bro, and he gonna step back and he gonna fire off with that uppercut and that left hook, and then, you know, you're going to be in a world of trouble. So Russell has to be, very, very, I mean, Diaz got to be very, very careful with his body attack. He can't just sit there and just plunge and just thud with the body shot. He got to step over, or he got to shorten him up and make him quick. For Diaz, he going to have to get his jab working as well, too. When he come on the inside, you know, stick double that jab up with Russell. And come in with his speed and his power, because he got good speed, man. And possibly punch with Russell. And that's what a lot of opponents scared to do. They scared to punch with Russell. Lomachenko, he became the boss in there, you know what I'm saying? He took charge, came on the front foot, didn't let Russell get in the head of steam. He pushed Russell on the back foot, and he was less effective. So if Diaz is able to put Russell on the back foot and be effective, that's a win for him. But I think this is going to be a unanimous decision. I think it's going to be closer to what people think. I think Gary Russell is going to just, you know, outclass Diaz just enough. I don't say it's going to be a big discrepancy. I think he'll win by 2 or 3 points. I think this fight's going to be closer than what people think. I think for Joseph Diaz, this is going to be a Danny Jacobs type of Triple G fight for him, where he might lose, but his stock is going to go up. His morale is going to go up. Moral victory, don't believe in those, but I think in this case, it might be a moral victory. I expect Gary Russell to win a nice unanimous decision, you know, by 2 or 3 points. I think it's going to be closer than what people think, primarily because Diaz can fight, and he's been active, and Gary Russell hasn't been active. But I got Gary Russell, 12-rounder decision. I think Jojo Diaz is going to go on and have an amazing career. And I give him a good shot to win this fight because of the hand injuries and the inactivity and some of the style matchup as I made. But be on the lookout for the Badu Jack, Adonis Stevenson prediction. But we got Gary Russell winning a unanimous decision, 2 or 3 points. We gone.